How's it going, everybody? Today, I'm going to show you how to swap out these for these. So you've probably seen my video I made a little while back, actually gonna be probably about a month or two ago, about the brand new Boost Auto Parts Switchback Light. They've been out for quite some time now. I'm going to show you guys how to swap out your basic regular strip or dot style turn signal lights in your Boost Auto Parts or any other aftermarket tow mirror, even your OEM tow mirrors. This would work for you as well. And I'm going to teach you how to put the switchback light in. And for those of you who don't know what a switchback light is, it's a light that will function as a running light and a turn signal. And the running light lights up white, and the turn signal lights up amber. Boost Auto Parts is the only place you can get almost plug and play turn signals. They're very simple to do, a lot easier, and a lot better looking, in my opinion, than the Morimoto strip lights that everybody else is doing. Even I have installed them before myself, and I think this is a lot better option. So we're going to go ahead and look over the mirror, and we'll show you how to take it apart, and we'll get these lights installed, and we can see exactly how to do that. First off, what you're going to need is a set of Boost Auto towing mirrors. You can also do this on any other of the aftermarket off-brand mirrors you might get from eBay or Amazon. Most of them are pretty much the same build, the same style. Boost Auto Parts has a complete different style of their own, but most of these steps are going to work on many of the other mirrors. There are some aftermarket mirrors that you cannot remove the marker light. I think 1A Auto has a set of mirrors out there that is completely different, and it's got a different... This works for your 2014 mirrors from your old body style trucks, your 88s to 98s, all the way up to your brand new 2018s. Anything that has this style of mirror, this will work with it. So what you'll need is that. You could do this on or off the truck. If you prefer to not take your mirrors off, like I do, because they are a pain to get to, and then you could just leave them mounted to your truck, and all of your work and all of your wiring and everything is going to go right behind the glass. So first things first, we'll have to pop the glass off. I'll show you guys how to do that. I do have a better detailed video of how to disassemble your tow mirrors back in some of the older portions of my channel, and I will throw a link down below in the description box on doing that, but I'll go ahead and get started on this mirror. You want to go ahead and push your upper glass down into the most downward position. The lower glass actually just pops right off. Let me get your hand in there, and it pops off straight forward. You kind of want to make sure you're going to do this on a more warm day, because if you do this when your glass is cold, they're pretty much increase your chance of breaking the glass. All right, now after you're done with the lower portion of the glass, you can remove the upper portion of the glass. What you want to do is you want to get your hands stuck into the top and slide your fingers underneath until you get your fingers into the middle where the base of the glass is. And then you want to gently remove the upper glass. Chances are you'll probably lose a clip or two, like I just did. And be sure you unplug any heat or power. And there's the internals of your mirror. Now your mirror has four screws. You got one, two, and then two more on the bottom that you can't see out of frame. What you want to do is get you a Phillips head screwdriver. And then once you unscrew these, your housing will come off, and you want to unplug your cargo lamp. Now to remove the light, you will want to make sure that your mirror is completely extended as far as it can go, because you will need to be able to move around the internals in order to get your light out. I would definitely suggest taking off the bottom of your caps, or else they might fall off and hit the ground, which for those of you who have them painted, probably isn't the best idea. And the light is held in by two Phillips head screws, one top, one bottom. Unplug the power. Use your screwdriver once again to remove the screws from the housing. And you should be able to move around just like so. Now, as seen in my previous video, we've got the Boost Auto Parts Switchback tow mirror lights that come in this really nice box. And you want to remove your lights. Here it is. This right here is the best part. The satisfaction you get out of removing the plastic from your lights is one of the best things. Now, one of the first major things you're going to notice is the plug style is completely different on the lights that you just took out versus your brand new switchbacks. Boost Auto has a cure for that. They are switching to this plug style, which is, I believe, was the same as the OEM plug style. And inside your box, you should have your wiring kit to wire these lights up to fit that plug. Here's your wiring kit. As you see, it comes with plenty of extra wire to do some splicing, as well as two different style plugs. You have your style to go into the new switchback, and then you've got a style like the old style plug. We'll get to that here in a minute after we put the light into the housing. Now, if you remember how we took the light out, putting the light back in is exactly the opposite. So you're going to take it, pull open your housing. You want to fit your plug into your hole and line things up exactly how they were before. Well, you've got your two screws lined up, you've got your plug in the hole, and you're ready to bolt your new light back down into the housing. And now you have your brand new switchback light mounted into your housing of your mirror, looking so much better than the old style dotted light. For those of us who like white running lights and amber turn signals, this is a good option for us. For me, it matches my front lights, where I have the white running lights on all three of these, and they turn amber when I hit my turn signal on. Now, if your mirrors did come with, or if you have installed the dual function harness, which allows the front lights to act as a turn signal and as a running light, you will have to remove that. So we're just gonna cut these wires that connect the module. It's gonna snip right here. We're gonna snip right up here where it connects to the plug. And we're gonna snip over here on this upper portion wire. After you've taken your dual function harness out, you wanna go ahead and strip the insulation off of the orange power wire that was feeding to your truck, as well as the wire on the plug for the pigtail that was originally plugged into your dot style lights. There will be another plug or another wire, which will more than likely be blue. You just want to leave that as is, as it will not be used any longer. You could just take that off and just shove it back here somewhere out of the way. Your wiring harness should have came with a couple of butt connectors. What we're gonna do is we're gonna crimp one to the orange wire. If you prefer to solder it, you can also do that. And then we're going to take the connector wire, the blue one, and crimp that into the other side of the butt connector, or solder it if that's what you prefer to do. Now, after you've connected these two wires, you're going to take the Boost Auto Parts adapter and just plug the Boost Auto Parts original harness into the adapter. Pretty simple and straightforward. It just plugs right in as it's supposed to. Now what you're going to want to do is find the hookup that hooks up the turn signal on your glass, which in this case is this blue one with the black and white wire. And we're gonna take the T-tap right here that's included in your Boost Auto Parts harness for the switchbacks, and we're going to put that onto the blue wire and secure that into place. Once you've done that, we're just going to take the red and blue powered wire and plug that directly into your T-tap. Now we've got the power wire from the brand new harness that you just installed. This wire will not be in use because we don't have the plug that functions with this. This is going to be for the 2014 mirrors. Some of them, they come with a different style of plug. So we're going to take this plug and we're going to plug it into our light. As that leaves you with this mess of wires. What I like to do is I like to take a zip tie and clean them all up and scrunch them all together and tuck them away in the mirror underneath the main power wire. That way they don't get caught behind your glass or something weird doesn't happen. At this point, we should have power for the turn signals as well as power for the running light on the switchback. So what I would recommend is doing a test before you put your mirror back together. Go ahead and turn on the running lights. We've got the driver's side, which has not been done yet. It is still the amber dot style LEDs. And on our passenger side, our fresh install of the switchback marker lights. Right now, parking has been lit up as bright, bright white. Now we'll check the function of the turn signals. And there we have it, just like that. We have installed Boost Auto Parts switchback turn signals. These are a great addition, like I said, to anybody who has a truck and they've got white LED front lights and they want to eliminate that amber turn signal and they want to have the strip style retrofit look without having the retrofit cost. Now, all we have to do is assemble the mirror, put everything back together, and we will be good to go. For my wires, I chose to zip tie them to the main wire running through the center of the mirror. That way it gives it kind of a more clean look, but yet you could still easily access any of the plugs that you need to get. For instance, this plug that will go on the glass can reach over to the glass still. And if you need to do anything with the plugs for the switchback light, you still have that access. Now, in order to put the mirror back together, it's essentially the reverse of what we just did and take it apart. We're going to put the bezel on, we're going to plug in the cargo light, we're going to put the upper glass on and plug that in, then we're going to put the lower glass on, which will complete the mirror. Guys, just like that, after you get your mirror put back together and cleaned up, you've got your brand new switchbacks from Boost Auto Parts installed in your mirrors and functioning as they should. Guys, I hope this helped you to be able to install these, and I hope you enjoy the looks of them on your truck as much as I do. If you have any questions, drop a comment down below or message me on Instagram. I'll be more than happy to help out. Take care, guys. We'll see you later.